टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद फर्स्ट यूनिट ऑफ पेपर बी, दैट इज़ बायोकेमिस्ट्री एंड एनिमल फिजियोलॉजी. अंडर यूनिट वन वी विल स्टडी स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शन ऑफ कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, प्रोटीन्स एंड न्यूक्लिक एसिड्स. सो टुडे वी आर टेकिंग अप स्ट्रक्चर एंड फंक्शंस ऑफ न्यूक्लिक एसिड्स. न्यूक्लिक एसिड्स, दे वर फर्स्ट आइसोलेटेड बाय फ्रेडरिच मिशर In 1870, he named them as nuclein because he isolated them from nuclei of pus cells. But later on, in 1889, they were named as nucleic acids by Altman due to their acidic nature. So this is the history behind it. Nucleic acids, they are macromolecules, they are polymer of nucleotides. They are mainly made up of carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen and phosphorus. So as they are polymers of nucleotides, so we also call them as polynucleotides. So now, first of all, we will study what is the structure of one nucleotide. One nucleotide has basically three components. These are nitrogen base. So a nucleotide has three components. These are nitrogen base, then is sugar, and third component is phosphate. Nitrogen base may be purine, it may be pyrimidine. Purine or pyrimidine. Sugar may be ribose or it may be deoxyribose. And the third component is phosphate. Now, first of all, purines. Purines, they are made up of double ring. They may be adenine. Purine may be adenine or it may be guanine. Adenine and guanine, they are made up of double ring. So first of all, we are drawing their backbone, CN, CN, CC, NCN. Then they are numbered as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Here there is present amino group. Then there is alternating double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond, double bond, single bond. Now in the third step, simply you have to complete the valency. Valency of nitrogen is 3 and that of carbon is 4. So simply by adding hydrogens, we complete the valency. So this is the structural formula for adenine. Likewise, guanine is also made up of double ring, CN, CN, CC, NCN. Likewise, we will number them as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Then here there is present carbonyl group. Here there is present amino group. Then we will again draw alternating double bond, single bond. And lastly, we will complete the valency. That of nitrogen is 3 and that of carbon is 4. So this is how structural formula of adenine and guanine is drawn. Pyrimidines, they may be cytosine, thymine and uracil. So here I am drawing uracil. So they are made up of single ring only. So single ring means carbon, nitrogen, carbon, nitrogen, carbon, carbon. Likewise, carbon, nitrogen, carbon, nitrogen, carbon, carbon. So they are made up of single ring. Now their numbering is done in this manner. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So now here in case of cytosine, here there is present amino group and here there is carbonyl group. So again alternating double and single bonds. Then you have to complete the valency, that of nitrogen is 3 and carbon is 4. And in thymine, here there are both, at both the locations there are carbonyl groups. So naturally alternating double and single bonds. And here there is methyl group. In place of hydrogen, here is methyl group. So like this. So this is the structural formula for thymine. Thymine and uracil, they only differ in position number 5. So that is, in uracil, in place of methyl group, there is present hydrogen. CN, CN, CC. So likewise, carbonyl group, carbonyl group. So here there is hydrogen. So this is the only difference. So we can say thymine is 5-methyl uracil. So these are the structural formula of nitrogen bases, which are 5 in number in case of nucleic acids. Adenine, guanine made up of double ring. Cytosine, thymine and uracil made up of single ring. Then there are present two sugars, either ribose or deoxyribose. Both of these are pentose sugars. So just see O, C, C. So pentose sugar numbering is 1, 2, 3, 4, OH, H, H, OH, H, OH, CH2OH, H. So this is the structural formula for ribose. Deoxy, as the name itself indicates, it contains one oxygen less. So this is the only difference. So here OH, H. So at position number 2, in place of OH group, there is present. So just see, this is carbon atom 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So they only differ at position number 2. So that's why deoxy means one oxygen less. So at position number 2, there is present hydrogen, whereas in case of ribose sugar, there is present hydroxyl group. This is the basic difference between these two pentose sugars, structural formula of these two pentose sugars. Phosphate is present in the form of phosphoric acid. So naturally, it is H3PO4 like this. So one nucleotide has three components, nitrogen base, sugar and phosphate. Nitrogen bases, they are of two types, purines and pyrimidines. Purines, they are adenine and guanine. Pyrimidines, they are cytosine and thymine and uracil. Then sugar may be ribose or deoxyribose, and this is the phosphate component. Now just see, depending upon the type of nitrogen base and type of sugar molecule, we name these nucleotides. So this is ribose sugar, this is deoxyribose sugar. If just see, nitrogen base, one nucleotide has one nitrogen base, one sugar molecule and one phosphate molecule. So if the nitrogen base is adenine, we will name it as adenosine monophosphate. If the nitrogen base is guanine, we will name it as guanosine monophosphate. If the nitrogen base is cytosine, we will name it as cytidine monophosphate. If the nitrogen base is, because we are taking ribose uracil, it is uridine monophosphate. On the other hand, if the nitrogen base is adenine, sugar is deoxyribose, and third component is phosphate, we will name it as deoxyadenosine monophosphate, then deoxyguanosine monophosphate, deoxycytidine monophosphate, and deoxythymidine monophosphate. So the point should be clear over here. In case of ribose sugar, we have taken uracil. In case of deoxyribose sugar, we have taken thymine, because RNA contains uracil and DNA contains thymine in place of uracil. So this is regarding the composition of one nucleotide. Now how the three components of nucleotide, they are linked together. The next point is, because we say nucleic acids, they are polynucleotides. It means, first of all, there is linkage between three components of nucleotide, and then adjacent nucleotides, they are held together. So to show it, just see how they are linked. So just see, this is the sugar molecule. O, C, 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 C. So this is carbon atom 1 of the sugar. So we may take ribose sugar or deoxyribose. Here I am taking ribose sugar. So as we have already studied, numbering is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Carbon atom 1 of the sugar molecule is attached to nitrogen base. It is attached to nitrogen base. Just see, if the nitrogen base is purine, this bond formation occurs at position number 9. If the nitrogen base is pyrimidine, this bond formation or this linkage occurs at position number 1. And the bond so formed, this bond is known as glycosidic bond. So carbon atom 1 of the sugar molecule is attached to the nitrogen base. Nitrogen base may be purine, that is adenine or guanine. Then this bond formation occurs at position number 9. If the nitrogen base is pyrimidine, that is cytosine or uracil, because we are taking ribose sugar, this bond formation occurs at position number 1. Whereas carbon atom 5 is attached to phosphate molecule. So this is how one nucleotide is formed. But because nucleic acids, they are polynucleotides, it means it is made up of large number of nucleotides. It means adjacent nucleotides must be held together by some bond. So just see again, we are drawing one nucleotide, taking ribose sugar, CH2OH, H. So again, carbon atom 1 is attached to nitrogen base. Position is same. Whether it is purine, then at 9 position. If it is pyrimidine, then at 1 position. And carbon atom 5 is attached to phosphate molecule. Carbon atom 5 is attached to phosphate molecule. Now just see, this is one nucleotide, this is the second nucleotide. Numbering is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now here just see, adjacent nucleotides, they are held together by a bond. This bond is known as, now this is between carbon atom 3 and carbon atom 3 of one nucleotide and carbon atom 5 of adjacent nucleotide. So this particular bond is known as 3 dash, 5 dash, phosphodiester bond. 3 dash, 5 dash, phosphodiester bond. So just see how one nucleotide is formed and how adjacent nucleotides they are held together. Now here just see again, carbon atom 3 is free for the formation of another 3 dash 5 dash phosphodiester bond. So that's how in nucleic acids, large number of nucleotides, they are held together by 3 dash 5 dash phosphodiester bond. I hope this much concept must be clear to you. That is, nucleic acids, they are polynucleotides. There are three components of nucleotide: nitrogen base, sugar and phosphate molecule. Depending upon the type of nitrogen base, we name these nucleotides. Then how one nucleotide is formed, that is, carbon atom 1 of sugar is attached to nitrogen base, carbon atom 5 is attached to the phosphate molecule. So these are the three components. And how these adjacent nucleotides, they are held together? They are held together by 3-5- phosphodiester bond.